something seriously wrong with that brand of Christianity in this day and age that doesn't stick out like a sore thumb, that doesn't rock the boat, that doesn't make any enemies, that doesn't get into any trouble, that just gets along, that just coasts. And there are marks of New Testament Christianity that are fearfully missing in so-called ministers and ministries in this generation. We know so much of the Bible, but when it comes down to it, at the end of the day, the only question that remains is, does the Bible know us? And I've been convinced of something over these years now, and that is that if a man sets himself, but especially a church, sets themselves, decides that they're going to sell out for New Testament Christian, they're going to get back and conform themselves back to what the Bible said was New Testament Christianity, that Satan will raise a conspiracy against them that is absolutely demonic, and will open up the very gates of hell and spew out all manner of fury and slander against such an one. But God will be with them. God will be with them. So we don't have to go looking for trouble. We don't have to go looking for persecution. God will see to it. Jesus Christ said, I am come to send a fire in the earth, and what will I if it be already kindled? And my friend, if you ever get baptized, filled with the Spirit of God, baptized with fire, you will be a fire in the earth. And if I may, it doesn't get any better. Christians really believe in this day and age that things have gotten better? Do Christians in this day and age really believe that the scriptures and the way of God's Holy Spirit as witnessed in the New Testament is any different and is going to be any different for us today? We need to wake up, stop lying to ourselves. You need to wake up, remnant of God's people, sleeping virgins. It's time to wake up. It's time to rise. It's time to trim your wicks. Wake up. It's time to examine your pastors according to the Word of God. Now, it was one thing for the Corinthians to seek a proof of Paul when Paul was right with God, when Paul evidently is bearing the marks of the Lord Jesus Christ in his body. But it's another thing when your pastor is evidently not bearing the marks of the Lord Jesus Christ, when he evidently does not look like the Lord Jesus Christ of the Bible, or Paul the apostle, or the other apostles. They were all persecuted. They were all slandered. They were all maligned. They all suffered at the hands of religious leaders and secular leaders alike, and they were all martyred.
Stand room in this day. It's intense. It's going to be much more intense in the near future, too. For these brothers, it's getting very, very serious.
But it's not. God is so great salvation.
So great a Savior, brother. To live as Christ, to die as gain. We are come, and I say, willing rather be absent with the body and present with the Lord, to live as Christ, to die as gain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain, that he might receive the reward for his sufferings. And that is men that aren't ashamed of the gospel. That's part of it.
There are many other things that I would say in regards to persecution. I would point your attention to the resources that we've posted under this video. And please take the time. There are many relevant sermons we have preached for years now on persecution because it's been relevant to us and because we believe that it is relevant to any true church in any generation. There is no society, there is no culture. If there is a culture that says that you can be a Christian and it's okay and we won't bother you, everything will be fine, that is not a Christian culture. That is an anti-Christian culture. And that's what we have been served in this generation, and most of the Christians in this generation have just bought into it.
How did they deal, my friends, in the scriptures with true prophets? They bound them, they sent them to prison, the false prophets, they stoned them. Listen, we love this man. I love him, I love Matt, I love all these guys. I just want them to know the true gospel. And I want you to know the true gospel. And it's better to obey man, God, than man. When Nebuchadnezzar caused everyone to bow down to that statue, those men, they did not honor the king, they disobeyed the king, and that's right. It's right when men are trying to bind your conscience to do evil to obey God rather than men. Why won't you guys consider that? That's why we're being cast out, because we won't obey. We won't obey Mike as our conscience. So we're going to obey God. That's why Martin Luther was almost burned by Rome, by the Roman Catholic Church, because he thought it was better to obey God rather than men. And he said, here I stand, I can do no other. And I'm going to obey God rather than men. May God have mercy on you all. May God have mercy on you all. We love you. God knows.
Since I follow Christ, I've never known such suffering. I've never known such adversity, such persecution, such shame, and such reproach. Since I've come to follow the Lord Jesus Christ, I've never known such ignominy. I've never known such behavior and lies being said against me. Not because I was a jerk, not because I was a liar, but because Jesus Christ is with me. Jesus Christ, the most holy, loving man that ever walked the face of the earth, was crucified. Jesus Christ, the most holy, loving, God-fearing, God-serving, God-worshipping man, was crucified by the most religious people. He was crucified by the most religious people. That should be a wake-up call, America. We say that we're the most religious, righteous, godly nation on the face of this earth. Why aren't there more people being crucified? Why aren't there more people, at least their reputations, being crucified? Where is your suffering? Paul said, all that will live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. Where is the persecution of Christians in America? I've gone to four and third world countries and I've preached there, and they say, you're persecuted even in America? And I say, especially in America. Especially in America. A Christian that's wanting to stand for Christ, to walk with God in this dark land, must suffer persecution. Must suffer persecution. Where's your persecution, America? Where's your persecution, Houston, Texas?
The Bishop of Gloucester said, don't ever let John Wesley or Charles Wesley in any of our churches. They were both certified men of impeccable morality, scholars, read Hebrew and Greek. Don't let them in the churches. And don't let that man, George Whitfield, in the church at all. Tell me who was the bishop at that time. Nobody knows. Don't care a hill of beans. But we know the men that got kicked out. You know, some of you guys, if you're faithful, you'll be kicked out. At least that's my prayer. I pray you'll all get fired for being fired. You know, some of you guys, if you're faithful, you'll be kicked out. At least that's my prayer. I pray you'll all get fired for being fired.